Solstice here, back with another Dig Dog! That's right. Today, we have a Sweet 16. It's gonna be fun. Alright, let me run through what we got today. Sweet 16, City of Orange, Orange Hill Restaurant, over off Chapman Avenue. It's gonna be a hell of a good time. Got about 150 to 200 people. This is a real Sweet 16, none of that fake backyard Sweet 16 party. Nothing wrong with those. I do those, but this is a real Sweet 16. We bring in all of that fire today. We got the CO2 cannons. We got the lasers. We got the haze. We got the lights. We got the strobes. We got everything. We got everything, just about. I have a lot more stuff, but limited to what we can do indoors. It's gonna be fun. I'm excited. I hope you are too. Join me along this magical journey we call Sweet 16s. I'm just messing with you guys. All right, let's head on out to the venue. It is hot out today. I'm roasting here. The sun is blinding my face. And I'm just ready to hit the road. So let's go on to it, shall we? We are here. Y'all check out this view. See the entire Orange County area. Unbelievable. Absolutely unreal. Look at how steep that grade is I had to drive up. Didn't need four-wheel drive. Luckily. But look at this. Can't beat those views. See that big silver thing way down there? I don't know if you can see that. Disneyland's right next to there, so I bet we can even see the Disneyland fireworks. But let's go on inside and find out. Let's go. We are all unpacked from the car, and you will see this setup done in 3, 2, 1. There it is, ladies and gentlemen. That is the final product. I think it looks nice. What about you? These lights are actually pink right now. Let me see if I can adjust the brightness, bring it down. Yeah, something like that. You'll see it. But anyway, this is the final product. Here's what we're working with tonight. We got two QSC KW181s, two QSC K10.2s. Bringing it around back. All that audio is being run through the Behringer ZNX 502 mixer, as is a huge M Audio Exponent, LPD8, MacBook Pro running Torque 2.0, U-Leader headphones, Shure SM58 microphone with that gold. Oh yes, look at that, dripping in gold. Continuing the lighting. We got the laser, it's being run off of QuickShow, which is what's on the screen right now. We're also running Freestyler on the same computer. In the background, I'm gonna swap between the two, do half screen, we'll make it work. So for the laser, we got the DS3000 from Laser World. One of my babies. We've got 12 of the wireless PARs all around the room. Some use as uplighting, some are using as crowd washes. We've got two Megaflash DMX, American DJ. We've got two of the CO2 cannons, 20-pound siphon tanks. This one, Airgas decided to give me one with the siphon that was broken. So here's a pro tip for you. If the siphon's broken, if all you're getting is air, tilt it on its side at an angle. That way all that liquid gets to the head. Moving on, two mini deckers. And I think that's everything. Oh, the CO2 cannons are being run off the American DJ PC4, basically an on-off switch. You'll see those in a little bit. And that is everything, everybody. Take you around the rest of the room. I didn't do uplighting on that left side because that's where that beautiful view is. Those are probably gonna be open later once it stops being so damn hot. There's the head table, got some lighting around the room. And we're also running a slideshow with a custom monogram that's spread throughout the slideshow. We're running the ViewSonic projector. I'll list the exact model number. I like it. I traded in my Epson for this one, and it is 10 times better, and the color is so much better. Happy birthday, Abigail. Custom made right there. So that is it. That is the setup. Let me know what you think. Let me know what you think of this this cool light tree setup idea. This is what I do in a lot of my gigs. I mirror everything. See, everything's just spot on. Might move that laser over a tiny bit. Everything's spot on and symmetric. That's kind of the look we're going for. And it is blinding my camera right now, so hopefully it still looks good. Either way, let's drop that down. Let's get on into it. I'm gonna go change into more formal attire, of course, because this is a nice occasion. And then we might hit that cinematic footage, because we've been on a roll with that lately. But yeah, stay tuned, because your boy will be right back. So quick overview of how I have Freestyler set up. So as you can see, I have it symmetrical. The right side matches all my right fixtures. The left side matches all my left fixtures. And I have a number of different override buttons. So there's a single color flash, you know, fast, fade flash, fast move. I'm not gonna go through each one right now, but basically everything is mapped out to this keyboard. There's different triggers. And yeah, so different triggers do different things. As you can see, as I move our way through, left, right, blackout, single flash, all that good stuff. So I will show you in a later video how this works, how I set it up, how I program my lights. But yeah, we're basically just using a bunch of quick override triggers. I also have some cues set up, some scenes that are, you know, different steps, sequences, chases, etc. And yeah, then I have a second page with just colors. We have a rose wash right now. So that's how that works. And a quick overview of Quick Show. You simply just click and you get a show. Oh my God, amazing how that works. So we're in the animal section right now, as you can see. So a lot of these come preset. You can adjust them, you can strobe them, you can use all these effects at the bottom. I have my own pages set up. I've got a matte beam and a matte other. Other is shapes and designs. Beam are just beam effects that look cool in the air along with some liquid skies. So yeah, so that's how pretty much that works. So you basically just take an effect, manipulate it, get it in your preview window, and drag it from the preview window onto any one of these pages where these map out to a keyboard as well. You can also use a launch pad type of device. Unfortunately, I don't have room for that right now. I do have a launch pad, but we're not using that tonight. We're just gonna make it easy. So yeah, that is pretty much it. And you can adjust the size and all that stuff. It does look a little weird since we're on a gray background mixed with wood, but that's okay. So yeah, that's pretty much how it works. And that is all, everybody. Next scene will be party time. Let's go. So we just got kind of a cool effect going right there. I really do love this software. It makes it so easy to control a laser. If you're trying to control your laser with DMX, make sure you get a professional laser that has a serial port, or as they call it, ILDA, ILDA. Because you could do cool ass stuff like this. The click of a button. Well, sort of. There's all sorts of cool stuff we can do with this.
Awesome. Thank you so much. You're welcome.
So many fun animations.
Sorry, one more question.
There's also all 151 original Pokemon. Can you name them all? Go, 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 go.
There is a little cat one.
Oh, is there?
Yes, it's a cat
one. There's also ones that react to the beat. So you notice there is a BPM counter right here at 128. So I could change that and it'll change the rate this guy claps at. Pretty cool. So that's all for that. Anyway, now we're gonna go get changed. Let's go.
Look, look and see. Just look how bad these last 3 years were to me. They brought me lower than you'd ever believe. No light to look up to. Oh, I know. Yeah, you know. You had it just as bad but never would show. You barely made it out alive on your own. Yeah, that's when I found you.
Shapes. It's really advanced. I can get into some of the more advanced features in a later video, but you know, for stuff like this, and I just use pretty basic stuff, but it can also, you know, specifically map to certain areas. It's very cool. So that's Quick Show in a nutshell, or a quick shell. But yeah, the room's looking good. Just waiting on the people. Oh yeah. And one final thing, everybody. I got a couple of those too. It's Donner, not Donor. Rick Webb's got an accent. It's Donner. D-O-N-N-E-R is Donner, not Donor. They're not organ donor. It's Donner, like the Donner Pass, the Donner family. I know somebody who is a distributor of their products, and it's Donner. Hate to break it to y'all. So let's please start calling it the right thing. Donner, not Donor. A birthday girl right there, everybody. Abigail. Check out that dress. It matches all the colors perfectly. Amazing. I just finished a delicious meal. I didn't film myself eating because why would I? You don't want to see that. Anyway, we are getting to the toast here in just a few moments and then we'll move along.
That's how you stay. That's why, darling, it's incredible that someone so unforgettable thinks that I am unforgettable.
Yeah. Yeah.
into a bag and pushed it down the stairs. I crashed my car into the bridge. I don't care. I love it. I don't care. Baby. Oh, baby. Why don't you just meet me in the middle? I'm losing my mind just a little.
Like that, another gig in the books. This one was fire, like all of mine are, of course. Random weird thing that we ran into on this gig. Let me know if you guys have run into this with the CO2 cannons. Every time I launched them, my computer would stop recognizing the MIDI from my controller, which is bizarre. I had them on the same circuit as everything else, like power strip, one of my power strips. Do you guys run into the same issue? After I switched it to a different outlet, everything was fine. But I kept wondering, I was like, oh my god, what's going on? I keep losing my MIDI source. Like, the computer would be fine, everything kept running, everything was totally fine. I just couldn't use my controller. I had to switch to internal mode for like 5 minutes until I, you know, turn the controller off and back on, and then it would happen again. But eventually we figured it out after a couple times. It's a big part of DJing is troubleshooting. Anyway, lit gig. That was my buddy Josh from Joshua Productions doing the lighting. So if it's not up to your par, you can rag on him about it. Just Google Joshua Productions. And if you liked it, well, hit him up, because he does lighting now. Anyway, that is it for this gig. Please like this video, leave a big thumbs up, comment, I love that feedback, and subscribe if you're new around here. Other than that, this is DJ Solstice signing out. Follow me on all my socials in the following little outro clip. And other than that, have an awesome day. Next video will be shot from the new iPhone, because it's got that 4K camera, and it's amazing. Peace, guys.